what's going on in software these days? Like, what should I be paying attention to?
So you got a few things going on. Crypto, obviously. Data engineering. Do you know anything about data engineering?
Well, I know it exists.
Yeah. So data engineering, when I started the podcast, the predominant thing you had going on was a lot of companies were figuring out how to deploy Hadoop. Hadoop was this thing that came out of the MapReduce paper from Google.
Yep.
And
yeah, Cloudera,
Hortonworks, MapR all started from the Hadoop revolution. And the Hadoop revolution really consists of two things. It consists of Hadoop MapReduce and the Hadoop distributed file system, which today has matured. If you think about those two areas of storage and compute, have matured into, you have a very big set of companies doing interesting stuff with compute and a bunch of companies doing interesting stuff on storage and then everything in between. You can think of Snowflake as a kind of a downstream, result of
HDFS.
I mean, Snowflake is a data warehouse company. When I was starting the podcast, the predominant view, I think, was that the way that things were going to go was that people were going to store all their data in HDFS, what is now known as a data lake.
Yep.
And it's like this really cheap storage, and then you do interesting stuff with all your data that's stored in the cheap storage. You load it into you either run Hadoop jobs or you have these stream processing systems like you have Spark, you have Flink, you have Apache Beam. These processing systems, you have your low cost storage and you have your processing system. And what's happened, which is interesting, is that those things did happen. Like, Spark is a huge business, obviously, with Databricks. Spark was kind of the winner in the next generation data processing framework space. Yep. But you had the rise of the data warehouse, which was unexpected. And what's interesting about data warehouses is you basically throw all your data in the data warehouse, and I think what Snowflake does, I've never used Snowflake, but I think what Snowflake does, and I think what Google BigQuery does, is it puts it into a tiered storage system. So some of it is at slower access speed, some of it's at faster access speed, and then you can tier it into memory, so it's like much faster. And so everybody is just using data warehouses because data warehouses take advantage of, they basically take care of all the lower level plumbing that you would want out of your data infrastructure. So instead of having to run like an HDFS and having to run like all this data infrastructure, you basically put everything into Snowflake. This is what made Snowflake such a popular company, I think. Like, people were originally doing this with Amazon Redshift.
I was going to ask. Like, this sounds like Redshift to me. But yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, Redshift did that. But then, Snowflake, presaging kind of a whole generation of companies that are not Amazon Web Services but provide you great infrastructure, said, we're gonna build an entire company around what Amazon tried to build a single service around. And that's what they've done. And there's going to be a whole generation of companies that use Snowflake as a platform, I believe. Whether it's you explicitly plug into your Snowflake or they just use Snowflake under the hood because it's such a powerful system.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm like, not financial advice, but Snowflake, not a bad bet, I don't think.
Well, Berkshire Hathaway agreed.
Did they put money into Snowflake?
Yeah. I think it was Todd bought into the IPO, in a pre-IPO round, put $500 million into the Snowflake's pre-IPO. Yeah.
Seems like a safe bet. Could be the next Oracle.
Yeah.